Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a common problems guide on the BMW N52 engine. Now, the BMW N52 made its debut back in 2004 and remained in production all the way through 2015, making it one of the longest running modern BMW production engines. It was also the final gasoline non-turbocharged engine from BMW following the period when the N52 was cut off from production. At that point, BMW's lineup was officially completely turbocharged for their gasoline engines. So the N52 is significant in a couple ways. It replaced the BMW M54 from the late 1990s up until about the mid-2000s. And then the N52 was succeeded by the four-cylinder BMW N20 engine. So anyway, one of the last, or the last officially, BMW gasoline non-turbo engine as of now. We'll see if BMW ever reintroduces a non-turbo gasoline engine. But since 2015, BMW's lineup has been completely turbocharged. Getting into the N52 specifically, there are two main versions or two primary variants of the N52. There's actually a couple more when it comes to power, but the two primary variants, there's a 2.5 liter inline six N52, and there's also a 3.0 liter inline six. And the 3.0 liters is really the main focus here, although again, very similar engines minus the displacement aspect, but the N52 3-liter variant is by far the more common, especially here in the United States and Canada. So the 2.5 liter, the smaller, mostly international engine, was found in a lot of the 23i models as well as 25i. However, in the US, those 25i models generally have the 3-liter, despite the badging indicating it would be a 2.5 liter. So a little bit unique there, but ultimately that 2.5 liter is good for anywhere from 174 to 215 horsepower, while the larger 3-liter engine makes 215 to 268 horsepower. So looking at the 3-liter N52, the main difference between power levels, a lot of it comes down to just tuning. However, another big change between the lower power N52 in both the 25 and 28i models and the more powerful 268 horsepower variant in the 30i models is that BMW implemented a three-stage variable length intake manifold that is also referred to as DISA. So those 30i models have a bit more power. It is an easy conversion to the other models where you could just take one of those DISA intake valves and throw it on one of the less powerful models, make a couple tuning changes, and they can get up pretty close to that same power number. So structurally, the engines are identical, minus that intake manifold and some software tuning changes. A little more background about the BMW N52. It uses valvetronic, which is BMW's term for variable valve lift, and it also uses dual VANOS, which is BMW's term for variable valve timing. It won the Ward's 10 Best Engines in 2006 and 2007, and is widely regarded as one of the most reliable modern BMW engines, at least kind of looking from 2004-ish onwards when the N52 made its debut and BMW started converting much of its lineup to turbo engines, which were less reliable and had a bunch of problems. So the N52 for this time period is often regarded as the most reliable, or at least one of the few most reliable BMW engines. Moving on, speaking of reliability, we're going to knock out a couple common problems with the BMW N52. Despite it being fairly reliable, no engine is perfect, and there aren't any exceptions with the N52, especially because it does have a few design elements that lead to a few weaknesses. One of the first problems that we see fairly often on the N52 and quite a few other modern engines like the N54 and N55 is failure of the VANOS solenoids. The VANOS solenoids have oil flowing through them. They control the variable valve timing, essentially. Over time, those get gunked up. They can electronically fail if they get gunked up. They start to work less effectively, and you might occasionally get fault codes indicating something's wrong with the VANOS solenoids. So there is an option too. You can remove them and try cleaning them. However, that's usually a fairly short-term solution, and the solenoids aren't terribly expensive. Depending on which brand you opt for, they're about $80 to $150 each. So generally, if you get this issue, it's best to just replace them. However, you can try cleaning the VANOS solenoids. And that usually at least buys some time. It might buy you a couple extra years or, you know, a few thousand extra miles on those solenoids, and they're pretty easy to take out and put back in place. And so cleaning might be worth a shot. But again, if you just want to deal with the issue and get it knocked out for good, simply replacing those solenoids is the best move. In terms of mileage, we've seen them start running into issues as soon as 50,000 miles. However, somewhere in like the 70 to 100,000 mile ballpark is a more common area to see problems with those solenoids. Sometimes they will last well beyond that, or they won't have any issues, but certainly one of the more common issues with the BMW N52 is going to be those VANOS solenoids. Next up is a problem that usually doesn't need to be replaced, or, you know, nothing needs to be done, and that is the hydraulic valve lifters on the N52. Most of it just comes down to not a great design of the lifters and cylinder head. So the lifters don't receive quite as much oil as they should. Over time, that leads to a ticking sound. It generally doesn't cause any severe issues or, you know, cause the need for anything to have to be replaced. So not really a major issue, but that ticking sound can be annoying. And if you're hearing engine ticking from the N52, there's a good chance that it could be those hydraulic valve lifters. If you do want to replace those, it's an expensive job. Taking it to a shop, you could easily spend $2,000 on those repairs. And it's a very challenging DIY. So a little bit of a headache there, but again, something that generally doesn't need to be fixed, and we would recommend probably not worrying about in most situations. That issue only affected the N52s through 2008, beginning with model year 2009, the cylinder head and lifters were slightly redesigned and tweaked, and that seems to be mostly an effective solution to those previous issues with the lifters ticking. So again, not a huge concern there, not something that we would put too much weight on, but worth discussing since there are quite a few N52s that do develop that tick, especially those models built in or before 2008. Moving on to a third common problem for the BMW N52, we have the water pump. So just like other engines of the same era, the BMW N54, even later engines like the N55, the N52 3-liter inline six uses an electronic water pump. And it has a couple benefits, but the downside is that leaves room for electronic failures. It's not belt driven like a standard water pump on, you know, 98% of engines out there. So a little bit of a different design on these BMW engines, and unfortunately it is a weak point. One issue is again that electronic failure. Another thing is it does use a lightweight composite impeller, so that's another thing that can break on these water pumps. Some people think an effective solution is moving to a metal impeller inside of that water pump, which has been tried and tested many times. And unfortunately, it's not the best solution because adding that extra weight from a metal impeller makes it more likely that that pump will fail electronically. So generally, these water pumps give out every 50 to 100,000 miles. If you get much more life than 100,000 out of it, then you're on the pretty lucky side of things. And unfortunately, there really isn't an effective long-term solution to that. And it's just something that is likely going to require replacement roughly every 50 to 100,000 miles. The thermostat is another part that ties into the cooling system that can also be problematic on the N52. Generally, not as big of an issue as the water pump. But anytime you do replace the water pump, it's best to just go ahead and knock out the thermostat at the same time. So water pump, thermostat, two common issues that are tied together there. Moving on to our last issue here, really a couple different issues that we're combining into one, is BMW N52 oil leaks. So the valve cover gasket and the oil filter housing gasket, just like on the BMW N54, are both going to be common problems. It's not quite as bad on the N52 since it is a naturally aspirated engine. You don't have quite as much pressure within the engine. Those gaskets tend to not fail quite as often. But again, valve cover gasket, oil filter housing gasket are two that frequently pop up on the N52. Those generally pop up in the 80 to 120,000 mile ballpark. So be on the lookout for those oil leaks. And speaking of oil leaks, of course, especially looking back at older N52s from, you know, the early to mid 2000s, these at this point, these are, you know, 12 to 18 year old engines, which with that kind of age, you know, any gasket, seal, O-ring, hose is prone to wear and tear and degrading. And so main seals, oil pan gaskets, those can and do fail sometimes, especially with, you know, that kind of old age and high mileage. So be on the lookout for those other oil leaks, but that's just kind of natural stuff that any roughly 15-year-old engine is going to run into a couple oil leaks here and there. Even reliable cars like Toyotas, Hondas run into oil leaks as they age and accrue more mileage. So overall, the BMW N52 earns average to above average remarks for reliability. By BMW standards, it's certainly above average. Kind of comparing the N52 to the greater car market or the greater engine market, it probably falls more in the average, maybe still slightly above average ballpark. Again, really the most reliable BMW engine from that roughly 2004 and until 2015 era. Moving into 2016, when BMW came out with engines like the B48 and B58, so far those engines are looking very reliable, and we believe that will continue into the future and that those newer B series engines will provide similar, if not even better, reliability than the N52. But again, looking in that early 2000s to about 2015 era, the N52 is widely regarded as one of the better BMW engines. So not really too much else to say with the N52. Keep up on maintenance, use quality oils, change fluids on time, do all the basics, and these engines can pretty easily make it beyond 200,000 miles without really running into any major issues along the way. A couple oil leaks here and there, a couple cooling system related issues, maybe a little bit of engine ticking. All that's going to be standard past that 100,000 mile mark. But outside of that, again, these should make it to 200,000 plus without running into any major issues that are really going to break your bank. Ultimately, if you're looking for a 3 liter, or, you know, naturally aspirated inline six from BMW, the N52 is certainly a great option, especially since there really aren't many more of these engines coming out from BMW. There aren't any in the modern day, and the N52 was the last of its kind in that sense. I think that just about wraps it up for our N52 common problems video. If you guys appreciate the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out some of our blog posts. We have tons of awesome content on the BMW N52. All right, thanks for tuning in, guys, and see you next time.